And how's it going, guys? It's Josh Olufemi. And guys, we have yet again the amazing VFX artist Herman Huang, aka Coffee Liquor, back on the channel. It's gonna be amazing. This tutorial is gonna involve making a fake LED screen. I'm gonna let Herman finish explaining what this is all about, but he is coming through from British Columbia, Vancouver, up in Canada. It's gonna be amazing. Herman, the floor is yours.
Thank you, as always, for the sick introduction, Josh. How's it going, guys? It's Herman here, and today we're gonna learn how to make a fake LED screen behind your subject, kind of like this. What's awesome about this technique is that you can use it for animations or text that will appear behind your subject, and the light fall off will interact with your subject, which makes it look realistic and pretty cool. Here's an example where I used it for a music video that I edited called North Hills. It was directed by the amazing Tyler Casey and starring Sui Generous. Check them both out. They're both incredible people. And there were two ways that I used it. One where the lyrics would appear in the background and it looks kind of like a screen. The person was in front of a green screen, so I thought this was a great opportunity to do so. And the second way that I used it was to have a sound effect behind your subject, behind the subject, and it would just kind of go like skirt, and I thought it was kind of cool. I don't know if you think so, but I thought it was pretty cool. And I just want to show you that there's a variety of ways that you can use this technique and any type of video that you wish, whether it's a music video or a promo video, commercial, you name it. As I mentioned before, what I like about it is how it interacts with the subject by giving it a light wrap, no matter what the animation or whatever is showing in the back. So it looks like it's actually in the scene and it doesn't look like you just slapped on something behind him through like Microsoft Paint or one of your earliest Photoshop work. You know what I'm talking about, we've all been there. Okay, enough talking, more editing, let's get into what you actually need. Now, it doesn't matter what type of footage that you'll be working with, however, the cleaner the background is, the easier and cleaner the results will be, because what you'll be doing is isolating the subject from the background. So the simplest way to do this is to put your subject in front of a green screen, or at least a background where it's a solid color that is not similar to your subject's skin tone or any article of clothing that they're wearing. But the footage that I'll be using today is going to be in a bit of a trickier situation where the background isn't as clean because, let's face it, sometimes we're handed off footage that is from the kind of directors that just like to fix it in post. I'm the post guy. That's how I'm able to bring you such knowledge today. Now, before we dive into After Effects, I recommend first installing the beta version of After Effects from the Creative Cloud, because today we're gonna be using Rotobrush 2.0 as the tool to isolate your subject. It is such a fantastic and powerful tool that uses AI to just give really, really polished results. Yeah, once you have that installed, let's cue the transition and hop over to the beta version of After Effects. So we are in After Effects beta, and this is the footage that I'm choosing to work with. Now, I'm choosing this one because it has not a super complicated background, but enough so that it can be a little bit tricky to isolate. But that is essentially what we're doing in After Effects beta with the Rotobrush tool. We are isolating our subject away from the background so that the background can be a fake LED screen. So in this case, as you can see, this is kind of dark. This chair kind of blends into the background a little bit. Although this is green, there are still reflections and stuff like that, but there is enough separation where we can get it away from the subject. So I'm gonna bring this clip into a new composition like this by dragging and dropping it into this icon. We're going to hit Control K because the time code is a little bit odd over here. You normally wouldn't have to worry about this, but if you're using stock footage like I am, then this may be a concern. And then I'm gonna change the duration to something like 5 seconds. We don't need to do all 17 seconds, especially with a footage like this, which is Ultra HD right now. And now we get to the part where we are going to use the Rotobrush tool, which is this one up top over here. Click it once, double click the footage, and then now we're in this window where we're ready to rotobrush our subject. So we can go to the very beginning frame over here, okay, the very start, and then adjust the brush size. And then how I do that is by holding control and then left clicking, but dragging left and right like this. And then with this green plus icon, we're gonna draw around the area that we want to include. Now for this part where it's leaking out, I'm going to hit Alt, which will bring it to the subtract brush, which will allow me to paint the areas that I don't want to include. And I'm just gonna make some further refinements over here, and then we're just gonna paint the rest of the things that we want to include. All right, so once we've roughly brushed around the areas that we want to include, you include those little small details like this. And then once you've done that, you can hit the shortcut Alt W, which will bring it to the Refine Edge tool. And then it'll turn into this blue plus kind of icon, this graphic, and we're going to brush around the area, paint it, that we want to refine the edge. So in this case, just using this left side as an example, as you can see, it shows a matte where the white side is going to be what's included and the black is discluded. So it does a pretty good job, especially with better separation. In this case, like I said, it's a bit of a trickier situation, so it may not do the best, but it's actually holding up quite well. It's keeping in all the hair like this, and then we can continue doing that for the rest of the edges. Okay, so this is what I have so far. If I look along the edges, it's keeping in all the things that I want to actually include. And then this is only the first frame, so we're gonna want to scrub through. Maybe I'm just gonna go only 4 frames forward, just as an example. But you're gonna do this for the entire duration of the clip that you want to use, and it's gonna propagate the frames. So on the 4th frame now, we can see if it's actually holding up quite well. It doesn't look like there's much movement, but when I move forward a little more where the subject actually moves, you can see that slight head tilt, kind of like that, and it's still holding up quite well. Now for bigger movements, it'll still do a great job. Rotobrush 2.0 is amazing like that, but you would basically repaint the areas that you want to include and subtract the areas that you don't want. And then once you're happy with the adjustments that you've made, you can hit this freeze button, which will freeze the entire clip, including the adjustments that you've made with the Rotobrush. So as you can see, once it is finished freezing, this is what it looks like, and you can always click this again to unfreeze it if you find that once you're scrubbing through it and playing through that it included some areas that you didn't want to include and you want to make some further refinements. Now in this case, for example, this bit of green background, I think I'm just going to manually mask out later, so I don't need to worry about that. I just want Rotobrush 2.0 to do the bulk work. But as you can see, if I turn the transparency grid on, it is now isolated from the background. The background pretty much doesn't exist. It's just this girl in this chair. And the reason that I'm using this footage is because she's wearing this VR headset, which I think would be a cool justification to add my own background. You can also make adjustments over here in the Rotobrush and refined edge effect, and you can change the feather, contrast, shift edge. You can even reduce the chatter. So the things that are happening over here where there are artifacts, you can always bring this value up. Same with the refined edge matte. Now, once you're happy with the results, I actually don't render it out right away. What I like to do is use this layer that I'm going to export, or this footage, I'm going to export it as a matte. So I'm going to use it as a matte instead of using this footage itself, because I find that something kind of weird happens where there'll be this kind of like drop shadow, which is a little bit odd and may not happen to you. But for me, my workaround is to add a fill layer like this. I'm going to drop it in, and then we can just change the color to something like white. And then I'm ready to render this out. So essentially, I get a transparency layer, and then I have this white blob, which is the outline and the subject itself. So I'm gonna hit Control M to bring it into the render queue. I'm gonna delete this top one, which was the previous render I had. But this one, we're going to change the output module to whatever that you want. In this case, I'm gonna go with QuickTime, and the default is Apple ProRes 444 for me, but you can also use QuickTime Animation. Because I'm using it as a matte, where I'm gonna use the black and white values of this footage, you can either stick to RGB, or you can go with RGB Alpha. Now what RGB plus Alpha is it retains the transparency in the background. So if you're using just the footage and not as a matte like what I'm showing you right now, and you want to keep the transparency, make sure there's a plus Alpha. In this case, I'm just gonna go with RGB because I'm just using the black and white. And then we're going to hit OK. And then now you're ready to render it out as you would. All right, we have moved over to the normal After Effects, not the beta version, where I'm a little more comfortable working in. And this is the original footage, as you can see, right? The girl with the background. And then now we have this pre-rendered footage where it was roto-brushed. And then as I mentioned before, it is gonna act as a matte where the subject is white and the background is black. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna drop this clip into a new composition by dropping into this icon like this. We can rename it to main comp, if I can spell it. And then we're gonna drop this on top as well. And then we're just going to trim the entire composition to fit with the length of this. As you can see, the time code is a little bit off. So I'm gonna hit Control K and then make this 0 so I can determine what this is. Okay, so 416, I'm gonna actually do 417. So that the entire composition, the duration of it, will fit with the clip. So I don't have that excess space to worry about. So now this is what it looks like. Kind of weird, right? Now, if you don't know what a matte is, it basically uses the data over here, either the transparency and the non-transparent areas, or the brightest part of the image, which in this case is white, and the darkest part, which is black, and using that as kind of like a mask so that you can choose what to show in the frame. If that was a bit confusing, let me just show you. Now, in this case, I'm gonna turn on the transparency grid, and if you render it out with just RGB, then it will be white and black and it will show nothing. But in this case, I actually exported as RGB plus alpha. I did this prior to what I taught you in this tutorial. So it doesn't matter actually if you're using this as a mat, but I wanna show you what it does. So I'm going to go to this base footage over here. I'm gonna actually call it base, like this. So this is not the roaded one. This is the one that I hide the visibility. I'm gonna hit Control D like this. And then I'm gonna hide the visibility of the roaded footage. I'm gonna turn on this, which is just the normal clip, right? And then we're gonna change the track mat to LumaMat. So LumaMat will show the areas that are bright, in this case white. AlphaMat will show the areas that are not transparent. So I can use either of these in this example, but in this case, I'll use LumaMat like this. And then boom, as you can see, it now cuts out the subject from the background like this, using the data that's in this footage here, the roaded one. So if I turn on the background, as you can see, nothing quite happens, but if I turn on and off the visibility, it's like the background is completely gone. So I'm actually gonna pre-compose these two. I'm gonna call it cutout because the subject is cut out like this, right? Now we are ready to start building your LED screen. Now it doesn't matter what you put in or what it looks like, but in this case, I'm gonna create a new composition that matches the same size as this one. So in this case, I believe it's Ultra HD, okay, like this. And then we'll just call it fake LED screen, like that. Okay, so this fake LED screen, we can place it on top of the base layer, but underneath the cutout. So it's gonna be sandwiched in between. Go back to this comp and then we start building the scene. In this case, I purposely use this footage to justify having a fake LED background because she's wearing this VR headset. So it looks like she's either entering into cyberspace or about to play a game, enter virtual reality. So in this case, for the fake LED screen, I'm gonna use a background from my digital product called Enter the Future. I'm gonna use the Rain one right over here. And if you don't know what it is, it's a motion graphic asset pack that I handcrafted and includes a variety of assets you can use for your music videos, commercials, live streams, narrative films, you name it. So if you need transitions or borders or custom texts or even backgrounds like this to give your video a modern edge or futuristic feel, I recommend checking it out. But in this case, I only imported the things that I'm going to use. There is much more than just this in this folder. But if I scrub through it, this is what it looks like. It looks like she's entering the matrix if I use this as a background. So if I go back over here, boom, looks like this. But there's going to be further refinements so it doesn't look like it's just simply slapped behind her. But I'm going to add a little more. I'm going to go to my emblems collection over here. And then let's use this motion graphic over here. And then we're just going to scale it up. We can shift it to, I don't know, soft light or something like that. It really doesn't matter. You're just messing around. So it looks like animation behind her. Looks like this. Pretty futuristic, pretty cool, pretty cyberspacey. Now this background that I'm using already kind of looks like it's an LED pixelated screen, but I want to talk about how you can actually make it look kind of like a fake LED screen if your background looks a little bit cleaner. So you can right click an empty space, go to new, go to adjustment layer, call it CC ball effect. Now I actually learned this technique from my friend Nick Koo, who is also an instructor on this channel, on the Josh Olufemi channel. So be sure to check out his amazing tutorials after watching this one. So I'm gonna bring up an effect called CC ball action like this. Oh, and to quickly run through what I'm actually using here is I'm using a free plugin called Effects Console by Video Copilot. So if I hit the shortcut Control Spacebar, just to not confuse you, you can quickly search up an effects or preset instead of going all the way to the preset panel over here. And what that does is it's going to create a bunch of balls to make it look like it's LED dots on an LED screen. We can change the grid spacing. We can change the ball size. It's really up to you on how far you wanna push this. Now, in this case, I'm gonna do something a little bit weird. I'm going to delete this. I'm gonna create a new solid by hitting the shortcut Control Y. We're gonna call it CC ball as well. And we're gonna apply the CC ball effect right over here. And then it's just going to affect this layer. I'm gonna change the parameters so it looks kind of like this. I'm gonna hide everything else. And what I wanna do is create some fake chromatic aberration to make it look like it's actually like a distorted LED screen, which is a very small detail I think will help. And how I'm gonna do this is I'm going to add an effect called set channels like this. We're gonna change the red source to red and then turn this off. Turn this off too. And we're gonna basically do an RGB split effect. So let's duplicate this by hitting the shortcut Control D. Okay, and then now we're gonna turn the reds to off, take the green from green, just like that. Hit Control D again. So we have three layers now. The top one, I'm going to and make it off, and then the set the blue to blue. And then now I'm going to set all this, I'm gonna highlight all of it, change the blending mode to screen. And now it looks like nothing has happened, but that won't be the case for long. I'm gonna play with the position of this by hitting P and just shifting it over just very slightly like this. And then now we get this little bit of a red cyan trippy type of RGB split. You can change the position for the other ones too, kind of like this, and now it gives this trippy effect. I'm going to highlight all three of these layers, hit Control Shift C so I can pre-compose it, and call it LED dots, like so. I'm gonna turn on the visibility of the other layers like this, and then we're going to change the blending mode for the LED dots to something like, where is it? I'm blind. Oh, there we go. Multiply. So now, as you can see, with and without, it adds these balls, and it has a bit of that chromatic aberration that we added, that little RGB split effect that we did, and now it looks more like an LED screen. So you can apply this to your cleaner looking backgrounds to make it look like LED pixel dots. So if I go back, boom, it's starting to look like an LED screen now. Once you're happy with the background, we are now ready to start making adjustments to make it look like the subject is part of the scene. First way of doing so is to color match it to the scene. So in this case, the background is pretty like bluey, cyan, very cool tones. And then the subject here looks like she is still in her office or whatever room she was in. But we want to submerge her into this virtual reality. So I'm gonna click the cutout layer, which is her cutout. And then we're going to apply a curves layer like this. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna darken everything. So it seems like it's kind of matching the tone of the background, and this is totally up to your taste, and you can always make readjustments going back and forth. But I'm going to go to red now, and I'm just going to bring this down so it's way more cyan. Looks like she's actually in that space. This is looking better already. I'm going to go to blue, and then we're just going to make it a little bit blue, not too much. And then go to green and make it look a little green as well. So right now, just by eyeballing the color to match it, it already looks much better. And then now we're ready to add the cherry on top, which is the light wrap, to make it look like the LED screen is actually kind of blooming around her and the light is wrapping around the subject. We're gonna take the two layers, the cutout and the LED screen, hit Control D so we duplicate it. I'm just gonna move it up a little bit. And then we're gonna hit Control Shift C, which will pre-compose it. And we're gonna call this light wrap, like this. We can change the color to something like fuchsia, so it's a little bit easier to differentiate with everything else. But we're gonna double click it so we enter this composition. And then here's the secret technique that I like to use for all my compositing when it has to do with something like this, where there's something glowing in the background. I'm gonna go to the fake LED screen. I'm gonna change the track matte to alpha inverted matte. And what that does is cut this whole thing out like so, right? And then I'm gonna add a new solid by hitting Control Y, change it to black. So it's a black background like this, hit OK and place it in the background. And what we're gonna do now is add a glow. You can do so by making a new adjustment like this, call it glow. And the plugin that I like to use is called Deep Glow. Now this is a paid plugin, but I use it all the time because it gives accurate light fall off and it makes the glow look absolutely beautiful. But if you don't want to spend any money to create this glow effect, then you can do it natively in After Effects. This is just a more efficient way of doing so to give really good results. But I'm just going to delete this. I'm going to just add in the built-in glow effect in After Effects because I want to show you that it still works. We're going to change the intensity and radius to something reasonable. So in this case, we'll do something like this. We're going to duplicate it by hitting Control D. Change the radius a little more, and we can change the intensity down. And then we duplicate it one more time, change the radius even more, and then we can bring down the intensity like so. So now there's a glow affecting everything and even leaks over this cutout area. And that's the part that's going to be the light wrap. So if we go back to the main composition over here, this is what we get. And then we're gonna duplicate this cutout over here by hitting Control D, just like how we normally duplicated things. And we're gonna slap it on top. And then now we're gonna use this as a mat by hitting this, the track mat, and then going to alpha mat. Now it's looking kind of weird where there's this black kind of subject, but there is this light wrap. And we're gonna use that by going to the blending mode and changing it to screen. And then as you can see, let's just use this shoulder as an example. If I turn on and off this light wrap, you can see that the glow is wrapping around the subject like this, which looks way better with it than without it. I'm gonna go back to the light wrap over here. I'm gonna actually delete all this glow, and then I'm going to use deep glow because I wanna show how that affects the light wrap. Go back to the main comp, and then now we have a pretty soft glow. And if you feel like it could use a little more glow, you can always duplicate these two like this, which is the light wrap. And then now you have a stronger glow. If you want it to spread a little more, you can go to this light wrap layer and then add in a blur. So in this case, I'm using Fastbox Blur. And then if I just change the radius like this, now it's softening the glow a little more. Now you don't want to get too crazy, because if you were to actually shoot this with a camera in front of an LED screen, it wouldn't actually glow like this. This is a little bright because the background isn't even that bright. If it was like a completely white background, then sure, it would bloom kind of like this and be even brighter. But in this case, there are not that many bright parts of the image, so it shouldn't glow like this. So what you can do is hit T while you're hitting the light wrap layer, and then you just play with the opacity, bring it down to something a little more reasonable. We tend to overdo things, especially if we like how it looks at first, and we're just excited to play with these new techniques. But in this case, bringing them both down to like around 50 makes it look way more realistic. So if I turn the visibility of these layers off like this, as you can see, this is without, and this is with. Without, with, without, with. And then now it's my time to congratulate you, because you are essentially done. I'm gonna open up this composition, which is the one that I work with, and I wanna show you the couple other details that I made to blend it into the scene a little more. So all I did was add a bit more motion graphics to make it look like it's part of the virtual space. In this case, this border over here is actually also from a motion graphic asset pack called Enter the Future. But another small detail that I added was this flare. If you turn it on and off, it helps blend the scene a little bit. And then I added a vignette down here, kind of like this, which is just a bit of a sprinkle on top to add some focus to the subject. And then for any imperfections of the roto brush, I just simply masked with the pen tool over here manually. And then when I play it through, this is what you're left with. And that is it. That is how you fake an LED screen or place any type of animation behind your subject. As I mentioned, there is a variety of ways that you can use this. The way that I like to use it is to add a bit of a punch to your video instead of, you know, overusing it. You know, having something like lyrics just appear in the background or an animation happen to highlight a moment, I think is the most effective way to use this. I'm not gonna tell you what you can or cannot do. If you want to have the subject in front of a fake screen the entire time, then what I recommend is having a green screen evenly lit behind your subject. That way it'll be easier for you to key out in After Effects and then apply what I taught you. Now, if you're into futuristic aesthetics and you like doing things like this, where you fake an LED screen behind your subject, and maybe you're looking for cool assets to complement your types of projects, then check out what I mentioned earlier, my digital product. It is a motion graphic asset pack called Enter the Future. Thanks to both the amazing Will and Josh, it comes with an unlimited license that allows you to use this for as many times as you like for whatever project that you wish. So it's like a toolbox that you just keep going back to for whatever you work on, whether it's music videos, commercials, wedding videos. Why not a futuristic wedding video? It comes with pre-rendered assets that you can just simply drag and drop into whatever editing software that you wish, or you can make customizations with the After Effects file that is provided, and also the Mogurt file for you Premiere Pro users. Make sure to stay tuned to the Olufemi channel so you don't miss the next tutorial. If you want to see what I'm up to, then check out my Instagram. The handle is @coffeeliquor. Until next time, let's bring it back over to Josh.
Herman, thank you so much for yet another incredible tutorial. Please make sure to like this video and to share this video with whoever you think may want to see it, and subscribe to the channel as well. Please make sure to remember to check out Herman's incredible ETF pack. That's what we call it, Enter the Future. I've been using it a lot and it's been freaking amazing. So guys, thank you again for watching the video, and remember to keep it chill.